such a good day and a great thing to walk in the light of the Lord. We may sit in His presence. Before I even preach, I want to give you a little small testimony. You know what the Bible says? He will give you so much that you won't even have enough to room to store.
Yeah.
And it's the reason why I'll come here and give you testimonies every day.
Amen.
Hallelujah! Amen. I will tell you my testimony. In May or June, you know where I work? Every 8 hours, they give you 1 hour. They pay you 1 hour. And I asked them, because at that time my children wanted them to go to Canada. I said, oh, I think you owe me lots of money now. Which actually at Swiss is about almost £800. And I said, pay that into my account. They forgot in June. In June, pay. They forgot. So it keeps going up anyway. That's fine. So I'm waiting. And then what happened is that, was it in June? I said, okay, Bertrand, get everything that is not fitting anymore from your cupboard. I'm going to renew your wardrobe. And it was Bertrand's month. I renewed his wardrobe. July, I said, now, June is your turn. Because before, it will be all of us. But now, you need to budget because the Lord is there. He's in the greatest part. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you give the greatest part to the Lord, so I need to, everyone has to have their own months. Now, I'm supposed to be in August. But it is a great day to serve the Lord. It is a great I need a bag. The Lord sent me a bag.
Hallelujah!
Yeah.
Hey. The week after, He sent me shoes. Amen.
Amen!
The week after, He sent me this dress.
Yeah.
And my friend,
yeah.
I didn't bring the bag today. But if you see, you're going to see that God doesn't make mistakes. Because the bag is white and black.
Okay.
Can you see?
Three
different people bought me things with the same colors.
Amen!
And I didn't have time to change my bag, just to show you. The bag, the dress, and the shoes, everything
Amen.
I received,
Amen.
Same color. I didn't have all the colors there.
Yeah.
The three people, and it was 3 different weeks. So my friend,
he's one person buying.
He's like, don't worry, you're not going to wait until August, let me do it. Hallelujah!
Yay.
So I have a good news for you this morning. Amen?
Amen.
The good news I'm bringing to you this morning, as I said earlier, it's something that started with like a word of faith, but it has been there, and the Lord wouldn't let me finish it as a word of faith, because He wanted to say something great.
Amen.
Is coming to you. Hallelujah. The Bible says believe. The Bible says believe. And I have some good news to you this morning. The battle you're fighting is not yours.
Amen.
Someone didn't get what I said. I said the battle you are fighting is not yours.
Amen.
We are suffering because we are taking it.
Yes.
But today you're going to leave it.
Amen.
Because when you understand that it's not yours and you leave it, then whose battle is it?
It is
God. And He is going to take it and fight for you. Hallelujah. When you work in the morning, you have in the afternoon.
Amen.
I was thinking August is going to be my month. I didn't have to wait for August to come to start receiving from Him. He's not going to take from you. Let Him take from others, but you belong to Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Don't let the devil lie to you.
No.
He's stealing from those who don't know Christ. He will try, but he cannot succeed.
Amen.
He will try, but he cannot succeed.
Amen.
Because Christ defeated him on the cross.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
That is the good news I came to give you this morning.
Amen.
This morning, the Lord has put a message in my heart.
Amen.
I don't even know if I need to go in there. Because the message has been nurturing. I wanted to go in. And the word of faith, like, no, don't worry, I'll just put more in your hand. That's the reason why you cannot feed the word of faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God. So many people are suffering out there because they are conforming to the world. While you conform to the world, you have the consequences of the world. You conform to the Lord, you have the consequences of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
There's no secret. It is God or the world.
Yeah.
It is the Lord or the world.
Yeah.
Choose.
Amen.
Today you're going to choose the right
heart.
Amen.
By leaving everything to Him.
Amen.
You know, we're going to read one. There's two more verses. But the longest one is one. And this is where the Lord talked to me. When He first talked to me, it was actually on one small verse where He says, it's not your battle. I sat there, I'm like, if it's not my battle, why am I praying then? If it's not my battle, why do I fast? If it's not my battle, why do I have to go to church? If it's not my battle, why do you want me to do all these things, Lord, then?
Yeah.
But He answered me, my friends. When He answered me, He gave me more courage to come here every day and kneel down.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He gave me more courage to come here and kneel down.
Amen.
I know now why I'm fasting and praying. He didn't ask me to go and fight. I have my little part to do. But the fight is where the greatest part is.
Amen.
The fight is where your solutions are.
Amen.
For Him to give you the victory, you need to do a little part. That part you're doing is not that big. You know, when you read the news these days, I want to tell someone that we see that there's war everywhere. There's war in the east, north, west, there's war. There's even war here in our cities. We see people being killed for nothing. Now they kill people like as simple as one is going to school. That is war. We are at war, my friend. Very recently we heard about someone being killed in Sudbury. A young man, 20 years old. You know, it is war. But the greatest war that we have to face in this life is ourselves. It's not the others. I will tell you something. If you don't put yourself in the right way where the Lord can rescue you, He can't do anything.
Yeah.
So the greatest war is yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But now, even though the greatest war is yours, is yourself, He's still willing to get you out of it. He's still willing to fight it for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And He has given everything to us.
Amen.
Everything. I want us to start with a little story. This is the story of a young boy, 16 years old. True story. In America, we hear that every day. I'm just giving that example, but there are so many even in the UK. 16 year old. 16. Rachel is 15. Next, in 6 months or whatever, he's going to be 16. And this young man, 16 year old, thinks that he has come to the end of his life. Why and how can the devil lead a 16-year-old young person? Because when you see 16, you look at your age, you're like, you haven't even, I have maybe 10 years more than you. What are you seeing in this life to say that it is the end of my life? How can someone get to that point and think, I am 16 and it is the end of my life? We may think, yes, that 16-year-old was desperate. Because that 16-year-old put an end to their lives, we think he must have been desperate. But I will tell you something today. Many of us, even in the body of Christ, are as dead as that young man. He is physically dead and maybe gone from this world. But many are dead because of some situations in their lives. So there's no hope for them. They've been praying for the same things. They can't see solutions, so there is an end for them. They come to church as a routine. Maybe God is going to look at me one day. Because you don't know the promises of God. He looks at you every day.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't know. But why is it that His promises are not taking root in your life? Because the battle, you're still fighting it. Today we're going to see that God is telling us that battle is not yours, it is mine.
All the battles of our lives, give me the other mic please.
All the battles of our lives, the Lord is willing to take them. Jesus said in the book of Matthew that those who are heavily laden should come to Him and find rest. If you look for God's rest, He will give you rest.
Amen.
If you're not looking for it, you're not going to find it. Everything is about looking for the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
If you want something, He will give it to you. If He's not giving, it means that you have to change. The solution is not where you are looking for. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But people are stubborn. You've been knocking at this door. Maybe there's no one in there. So knock at the other one. If you're knocking, it's, the Bible says knock, it shall be open.
Amen.
If I knock here.
And it's no answer?
Eh? Talk, talk. I'll even go like, let me hear if I can hear noise.
Someone inside.
Is no noise? Why would I stand here? How many Christians are standing there? Keep knocking, knocking.
Yes.
No noise.
No.
They haven't even looked down. You know, there are some doors where you can see if there's light in. They can't see even light down coming out. Like there's light there. But they're still standing there. Just move.
Yeah.
When you knock. Oh, noise. Please. Hey, I've been here a long time. Please open now. Whoa. Why can't you see me? My friend, the day I understood that, my life's changed.
Amen.
If I knock and pray certain ways of working, I'll stop praying first. Lord, what do I do? Seek God first. Seek God first.
Amen.
Because you may be praying. Your solution is in praying for someone else.
Mm-hmm.
You may be praying. Maybe I was like, Lord, give me this, give me this. God is like, I'll give it to you when you start praying for your sister who needs the same thing.
Amen.
That's the reason why I keep knocking. Give me, give me. It's like, one day you will understand.
Mm.
Amen?
Amen?
The battle is not yours. There are battles God doesn't want you to fight for yourself. Something has been too much for you.
Yeah.
You're not getting solution because you're still praying for yourself. Stop praying for the people. We have the young man was here last time. I gave him that. I said, you know what? Just take 1 week, just pray for all the people. And he gave me the testimony. He said, after 3 weeks, he came back like, it works. I said, the promise of God are yes and amen. It's not no, it works. Apply the principles of God. Amen?
Amen.
The thing is that when we look at our world, the world has changed everything. The society is losing the battle every day. We see it even in our homes. The world, the society has made it to look like it is normal to be a single mother. My friend, you may accept it, may I say no to it?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because it's not that written like that in the Word of God. Have you seen a single mother? Why do we accept it? And I will tell you why many people will remain where they are. Because we're not changing our mentality. Knowing that is not normal. You know, before, let's go back in the past. Man was the breadwinner. Today, woman has become powerful because society has removed all the power to man. So even man comes at home, he can't talk anymore. You start even blackmailing them with their children. The children that you had with them, you didn't buy that child. If that man wasn't there, you wouldn't have had that child. Because you know that the society is backing you up. Let's speak the truth. And you think that you're in that condition and God gives you something? The society is the world.
Yeah.
God is God.
Amen.
He's not going out of his principles.
Amen.
Man remains man.
Amen.
Created before woman.
Amen.
Which means that society has changed the rules. But I am telling you that the society can change if things don't come back to where it is. This society will never be right.
Mm-hmm.
That's the reason why we are suffering. But God has a solution for us.
Amen.
And look at what the society is also doing. At the same time that they remove all the power from man, giving it to women, the same society is degrading women. Now it's normal for a woman to stand on TV naked.
Mm.
All the videos, even adverts, you know, they're watching an advert for yogurt. And then you see a naked woman with her little panty going like this. I'm like, what? A yogurt that I'm eating, why do I have to see a naked woman? Is that normal?
Yeah.
No.
As
let's talk about the reality.
Amen.
Because this reality is to tell you that the world has lost the battle. But we are not in the world.
Amen.
We are the children of God. So if we look at those things and think it's normal, it means we are also lost the battle. While you're still looking at these things and it's normal to you, you can never receive the promises of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God doesn't give his word. Women are disgraced sexually, emotionally, physically, because they were given too much power. That's the problem. Too much power. I remember my little sister telling me this story one day. She wanted to eat. Listen, she's home. She feels like, I want to go to a restaurant. She wants to go to a restaurant, but she doesn't want to pay for it. Now she wants to use a man to pay for it. Yes! That's what society teaches us, because we're no longer afraid of anything. She calls this man because she knows that the man likes him a bit. She calls another cousin. They will go to the restaurant. And she agreed with the man, yeah, after we finish, I'll go home with you. When they finished eating, she went to the restaurant and the guy is like, are we going? She said, excuse me, don't you think I have a credit card? Do you really think that I needed you to pay for this? Because she really didn't have the money. She didn't have the money. Why are you telling me going home with you? Excuse me, do you want me? I have a credit card, I have a card, so I don't need. The truth is that she didn't have, and she just wanted to go to the restaurant. How can we be at peace? How can we be at peace? Can we be at peace?
Yeah.
God has made things in a way that the society has degraded.
Yeah.
And as long as we live seeing things the way the society has exposed, we can never enter God's plan.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So if you want God to take your battle, you would need to leave the society and its rules to accept God's rule so that he can recognize himself in your life.
Amen.
As simple as that. There are so many things God wants to do for us, my friends.
Yes.
But he's not going to do it like that.
Amen. Amen.
This young man, 16 years old, why is it this young man decides to finish with his life? The society gave him power. You can live without your parents. We can give you a shelter. And then one day the society abandons him. What is going to happen? What's going to happen? They gave you power too early. Now, when they're no longer with you, you don't know. But is, was God not right making it that the child has to be
under
the authority of a father and a mother until they are mature enough to live and start living?
Amen.
But then the society removes that, starts looking after you. Can society love you more than your parents? Can society really care for you the way they're saying they're caring? Let's be real. Reality is in the Word of God. If we are there in the world, we are not in the Lord. If it is the solution to look after yourself, don't be dependent on the society, depend on the Lord.
Amen.
Because society will disappoint you. Man will disappoint you. The Bible says that whoever trusts man is under a curse. You trust the society more than God. You want a house, Lord. Oh, you go behind the council, find me a house, find me a house. My friend, I was near God. Lord, I want a house. I don't have anything to do with that. You said I'm going to live in houses that people built.
Amen.
That's the promise of God. Did God tell you going to see the council?
No.
He said, kneel down.
Amen.
That's why he said we need to fast and pray.
Amen.
You want solutions that come from God? Let's live according to his word.
Amen.
What you want for your life is in God.
Amen.
The society can give you and take back, just like the devil.
Yes.
And what God gives. Hey,
amen.
The Bible says, what God gives, my friend, what God gives, there is no regret. You will never regret it. Up till now, this man sent me a message last time saying that we're going to meet us when I'm coming from Italy to sign the contract. He still trusts me. He's still here. You know, that's how it is. God will put you in favor.
Amen.
Yes. The favor of God goes ahead of you.
Amen.
No one is bothering you. Have you seen where the council gives you a house? You're even sitting there, they say, we're coming and check. We're coming. What do you come and check in my house? What? Can you say what's your right? Say, you gave it to you?
Yeah.
But God is not going to say, I'm coming to check.
Amen.
He just wants you to apply his rules so that you don't lose what he gave.
Amen.
As simple as that.
Amen.
Apply his rule, keep what he wants you to keep it. Because he's not going to come and take it back. Even when you're messing up, he's even there saying, hey, what are you doing? You want to lose what I gave you?
Yeah.
The society wants you even to be in debt.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They'll start telling you, oh, you can even buy this. We can even help you with credit.
Yeah.
God is not going to give you credit.
Yeah.
He's going to say, take it.
Amen.
Give it up to the Lord. Take it.
Amen.
It's yours. I put it down for you even before you were born. with a credit card. He said, no, 30 months free interest. I said, even if this is yearly, even if this is whole life free interest. I was in credit card. I threw them in the bin. You're not taking me back to Egypt. I don't want to hear stories. I don't need credit cards anymore. I need debit cards. I have debit cards.
Amen.
When I put there is. Hallelujah. I don't want. Because the Lord changed me from credit to debit. Hallelujah. Because before, when I need something, hey, credit card here. And I had that facility they would give me. At some point, I had three of them in great amounts. And now when you miss one payment, you even start falling up, answering your phone. When they call you, please, I know who it is. Since God gave me only debit card, I just answer my phone. Who is it? Please, don't even call me anymore. Thank. don't bother me. Now I speak loud. They were speaking loud before. Hallelujah. Yeah. You don't have debit card.
Amen.
What bag do you want?
Amen.
What do you want? God is good. What do you want? Jesus said, come unto me, you that labor. If you have a heavy laden, bring it to me. I'll give you rest. The battle is not ours, my friends. The battle is not ours. We're going to read from the word of God now. Can someone please take it for us? It's a long one, but it's worth it. And I want you to see those that are stressed. When you read, I'm going to stop on them. Can someone read it for us, please?
This is what I'm wanting.
Is yeah. 2 Chronicles.
Mm-hmm.
2 Chronicles 20:1-22.
I read in the name of Jesus.
Amen. I just want you to focus on those things because I'm not going to be recording all of it, but those that are on the line because it gives you the stages of God's work.
After this, the armies of the Moabites, Ammonites, and some of the Meunites declared war on Jehoshaphat. Messengers came and told Jehoshaphat, a vast army from Edom is marching against you from beyond the Dead Sea. They are already in Hazazon Tamar. This was another name for En-Gedi. Jehoshaphat was alarmed by this news and sought the Lord for guidance. He also gave orders that everyone throughout Judah should observe a fast. So people from all the towns of Judah came to Jerusalem to seek the Lord. Jehoshaphat stood before the people of Judah and Jerusalem in front of the new courtyard at the temple of the Lord. He prayed, O Lord, God of our ancestors, you alone are the God who is in heaven. You are the ruler of all the kingdoms of the earth. You are powerful and mighty. No one can stand against you. O our God, did you not drive out those who lived in this land when your people arrived? And did you not give this land forever to the descendants of your friend Abraham? Your people settled here and built this temple for you. They said, whenever we are faced with any calamity such as war, disease, or famine, we can come to stand in your presence before this temple.
Hallelujah. Hold on there before we continue. Who built the temple for the Lord?
David.
No, here. Yeah. But it's the people of God, isn't it? Now, what are they saying? Whenever we are facing with calamity, where do we go?
In the temple of the Lord.
Let's continue. Move on.
Before his temple where your name is honored. We can cry out to you to save us and you will hear us and rescue us. And now see what the armies of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir are doing. You would not let our ancestors invade those nations when Israel left Egypt.
Yeah.
So they went around them and did not destroy them.
Yeah.
Now see how they reward us. For they have come to throw us out of your land, which you gave us as an inheritance. O our God, won't you stop them? We are powerless against this mighty army that is about to attack us. We do not know what to do, but we are looking for you, to you for help.
We are powerless because there's an army. The army is more than us. And he said something. Remember this. We do not know what to do. Let's move on.
But we are looking to you for help. As all the men of Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, wives, and children, The Spirit of the Lord came upon one of the men standing there. His name was Jahaziel, son of Zechariah, son of Benaiah, son of Jehiel, son of Mattaniah, a Levite who was a descendant of Asaph. He said, "Listen, King Jehoshaphat. Listen, all you people of Judah and Jerusalem. This is what the Lord says. Do not be afraid."
Who said it? The Lord.
The Lord said.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Don't be discouraged by this mighty army.
Amen.
Let's follow him. This is what the Lord says. Repeat what the Lord said.
Do not be afraid. Don't be discouraged by this mighty army.
Hallelujah. Keep going.
For the battle is not yours.
Hey! Sorry! Read it again.
But the battle is not yours, but God's.
Don't be discouraged by that problem that is bothering you. Don't be discouraged. Don't be afraid when they come and knock at you. Where's my rent? For the battle is not yours. It is whose?
God's.
Oh, okay. I heard that. Continue.
Tomorrow, march out against them. You will find them coming up through the ascent of Ziz at the end of the valley that opens into the wilderness of Jeruel. But you will not even need to fight.
No.
Hey! You will not even need to what?
Fight!
Hey! Did I say it?
No.
Who said it?
God!
Let's continue.
Take your position. Then.
Thank you! What did you say?
Take your position.
What did you say?
Take your positions.
I think many are not in their right position. That's the reason why the battle is too
much. Take your position.
Let's move on.
Then stand still.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
I'm coming. I will preach yet.
And watch the Lord's victory.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He is with you, O people of Judah and Jerusalem. Do not be afraid or discouraged. Go out there tomorrow, for the Lord is with you. Then King Jehoshaphat bowed down with his face to the ground. And all the people of Judah and Jerusalem did the same, worshipping the Lord. Amen. Then the Levites from the clans of Kohath and Korah stood to praise the Lord, the God of Israel, with a loud shout. Early the next morning, the army of Judah went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. On the way, Jehoshaphat...
This is my early in the morning.
Yeah.
I've already given a Bible study about early in the morning. My friends sleep. Yeah, get up early in the morning. Continue.
On the way, Jehoshaphat stopped and said, "Listen to me, all you people of Judah and Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and you will be able to stand firm. Believe in his prophets, and you will succeed."
Amen.
After consulting the leaders of the people, the king appointed singers to walk ahead of the army, singing to the Lord and praising him for his holy splendor.
Hallelujah.
This Amen. Is what they sang. Give thanks to the Lord. His faithful love endures forever.
Amen.
And
22? Yes, continue. Listen, they are singing praises to the Lord, but they are still in the problem. Listen, read the next bit.
At the moment they began to sing.
At the moment they began to sing and praise. What happened?
The Lord caused the armies of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir to start fighting among themselves.
Amen.
Let's give a clap to the word. How do you want me to preach again here? How do you want me to preach again? Because God says everything. The problem is that when someone has a problem, "Hey sister, hey brother, what do I do? What do I, oh, I try." Who asked you to try? Who asked you to call brother and sister? Sing praises to the Lord. It is a great to serve the Lord. As you are thinking that you don't know the army that the Lord is sending, the fire that he's sending, the oh Lord of grace. If the Christian will understand this, he said, for you to have his victory, stand still in the right position. Be in the right position, verse 17. In the right position and stand still.
Amen.
Stand still doesn't mean, brother, what do you think I can do? You ask brother, brother hasn't given his answer, you are already in sister. Don't we do that?
Mm-hmm.
You're already, you what? Then everyone will give you their opinion. Now you are even more lost than you were in the beginning.
Yeah.
learn to stand still.
Amen.
But in the
Amen.
There's no secret. Look what he said. Earlier, he said what? They built the temple, and where did they go to see God? No, my body is a temple of God. I can look for him in my bedroom. I don't need to go to church. Continue! Continue! That solution you're waiting for is not going to happen. God wants serious people. God, we just sang that he's an excellent God, my friends. An excellent God doesn't take mediocre things. An excellent God also looks for an excellent relationship. You're not going to use him as we do, because that's what society is teaching us. I just gave you the example of my sister. The other thing I'm going to give you this morning, I remember once I went to France. My sister is driving the car. I think I got my license 2 months before her. So we've had the license the same year. Yeah? Now, no, it was 2 weeks, sorry, 2 weeks, same month, 2 weeks before her, same month, same year, twin license. She's driving the car. When she's driving, I'm like, because I don't want to see you going too fast, I'm braking. You know, sometimes, don't you think, you know, and then one day I remember she told me, oh, she had a little accident. In my back head, I'm like, the way you drive. Truly, do I really drive better than her? Do I really drive better than her? No. No. But the thing is, that is how we do. God want to take control, but we want to keep the brake. You're going too fast now, God. Stop. No, I'm not ready. You know what you want to do? Then I'm not ready. He's like, okay, you're not ready. Well, I will just let you finish. When you're ready, come. And I'll still wait for you in the same way. You want to take control because he's seen you crying. You've come into his presence, Lord, I give you this. As soon as you leave, you have taken it back. You come to him, Lord, I give you this bottle. You left it here, kneeling down, fasting and praying. When you leave, oh, I forgot the bottle. You yourself come back, let me take it. You take too much time, Lord. I'll deal with it. Don't we do that? We do that. God wants, when you give him something, wait on him.
Amen.
Still, if you don't do that, he cannot act, my friends. God is there to do what we cannot do. He's the God of the impossible. It is when the situation is where you think, I don't know. What did they say? We don't know what to do. Can you truly tell me that there are no things in your heart, that life here, where you're like, Lord, I don't know what to do? Mm-hmm. If you are saying this, pay this and do exactly like them. Mm-hmm. Fast, pray, hear. Kneel down day and night and stand still. God is not telling you to go and fight. I remember when she called me, oh sister, that car they promised has not come. What did I say? I said, when you were looking for the job, did you go to them? You went for God. So they promised something that's not coming. Why do you ask them? Go to God. Mm. What is your problem with them?
It's true.
And did it make it, was it long?
I won't know that day. I prayed to God, I asked God for it.
Exactly.
And I remember asking them that same day. He said, oh, we've ordered it.
Mm-hmm. I said, why? And she was telling me, I'm going to go and tell her. I asked them. I said, why are you asking them? Did you go to God? Now he's actually asking them what's taking the problem that you've given to God to deal with it. I said, you go to God and said, that thing it's your promise. That job came with this. Why is that you don't have it? What has the employer to do with it? I said, kneel down and go back to the Lord. You have nothing to do with the employer. The same evening, she's calling me and said, hey, sister, prayer works. I said, of course it works. That's the reason why you see me preaching. That's the reason why you see me every day dancing.
Amen.
If it didn't work, you think I would still be here? I'd be like, But I've seen that the word's not working. I've seen it. So many fights I've done out there. So many things that I have seen. Promises that have never come true. Promises in the world not coming through, and then you start being angry. You get angry with yourself, you get angry with the world first, and then it becomes worse when you get angry with yourself. That is the reason why a young man 16 can think this is the end of my life. And that's what the devil is doing out there. He wants us to trust the world more than we trust God, so that he can truly finish with us, because he knows the great things that God has with us. Is there someone here who wants God to deliver them.
Amen.
You see, the Bible says, I want us to read Psalm 116. It's there. Can you put it, please? Verse 3 to 8. That song tells us something. And we're going to understand why a young man can be desperate. Because this is, David is finding himself in a situation, just like this man must have been. Can someone read it for us very quickly? It's when the sorrow of death, everything has taken total control of you.
Yeah.
Everything. Yeah. In this situation, there's no more light. You can't see how you're going to get out of it. You can only see death as an end.
Yeah.
That's why you see people taking out their lives. But we Christians, we cannot be like them. There are parts of our lives where that sorrow of death is still right there as I'm talking. And it's not right. It's not because we don't see, you know, like those who commit suicide. But there are parts of our life where we have even led it into suicide. Can't you see? There are people who, you hear someone say, oh, you know what, I'm fine. You know deep down they want marriage, but you know what, I'm fine, I don't need a man. But when they are alone in the mirror, they start crying. Because it's just a facade. Let us read Psalm 116.
I read in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I love the Lord because he hears and answers my prayers.
Amen. He does.
Because he bends down and listens. I will pray as long as I have breath.
Amen.
Death had its hands around my throat.
Amen.
The terrors of the grave overtook me. I saw only trouble and sorrow. Then I called on the name of the Lord. Please, Lord, save me. How kind the Lord is, how good he is. So merciful this God of ours. The Lord protects those of childlike faith. I was facing death and then he saved me.
Amen.
Now I can rest again, for the Lord has been so good to me.
Amen.
He has saved me from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling.
Hallelujah.
And so I walk in the Lord's presence as I live here on earth.
Amen.
Amen.
I believed in you, so I prayed. I am deeply troubled, Lord. In my anxiety, I cried out to you. These people are all liars.
What? Eight.
Up till
eight. Amen. That's fine. Amen. Hallelujah. What I want to say here is that when the sorrow of death has taken all an area of your life, or even your own life, call on the Lord.
Amen.
Call on the Lord. Amen. Don't call on Sister Regine. I can do nothing for you.
Amen.
And you've seen that whenever you come, I'm like, word of God and prayer, isn't it? So, why don't you just call on him directly? Because he will tell you the same thing. Word of God, prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
David praying before him. He took David as a prey. I need to eat you. I'm going to kill you. David is finding himself in that condition. What did he do? Only one person can deliver me. And it is him. Call on the Lord. Call on him. Why do you see people desperate out there? It's because they don't know the Lord. You already know him. Why would you feel desperate? Why would you feel like you have no one? A solution, there's a problem in your life, in the life of another person in your life. You are looking for whom? Call on the Lord. Not only for yourself, but for people around you. Call on the Lord. Call on the Lord. Call on the Lord. He's waiting for us to call on him, my friends.
Amen.
He is waiting. He sees how we are suffering. That's why sometimes he put that suffering. He brings you to see a situation and you cry for the person. You don't know why you're crying. It's not your problem, but it's not you crying. It's God who is crying. Do you think that God is happy seeing us suffering?
No.
He's not. If you can have tears over someone else's situation, sometimes you watch TV, you have tears in your eyes. Do you think it's your tears? It's the Spirit of God in you that is grieving. That's how we're suffering. So if God, can you imagine? God is like, I did not create them to suffer this way. Can someone call on me? Why are you crying? Just call on me. God cannot act. He doesn't force his will in our lives. My friends, he does not force his will in our lives.
Amen.
God asks when we call on Him.
Amen.
You want my help? Come to my house. Mm-hmm. I can know that you're suffering. I may not even give you a phone call. But when you are there in front of me, even I'll go in my kitchen and say, hey Lord, should I ask this person if he wants to eat? Because I can see, now you're in my house, it becomes personal. It becomes my problem. Mm-hmm. You want God, you are out there, you want God to take something, His, while you don't want to come closer to Him? Mm-hmm. It's not working. It's not working. Call on Him, but according to what He said in His word. Then He will act. You know, God has not left us alone. He gave us the Spirit of God. Through the Spirit of God, we have access to so many things. You know what? You cannot. God is amazing. He's amazing. Mm-hmm. My friends, I've seen so many things this week. Spending time here. Yesterday I was here alone. I started praying. The Spirit of God led me to pray for someone. I'm telling you, I've never seen that person. Another person from the internet wrote me something. I came here, I didn't think about that person. I was here. I started interceding for someone I don't know. I don't know. That person wrote to me maybe once or twice. I don't know how it came, where it came. It was 7, I was here. Around 7:30. Then when I went home, I'm like, what's even this person again? Let me go, just go and check that person. Just to even see that image, to know how they look. Can you believe that? Can you believe that? God wants us to call on Him for others. God wants us. He wants someone to stand in the gap. He wants to do things so that young people are not going to be killing themselves out there. You know, there's something that is really making me think these days. Why is there so much mental health in this UK?
Yeah.
I've been wondering, is there something in the water? You know, I lived in France for more than 20 years, but I haven't heard of cases of mental health the way I've heard in the UK. I'm telling you the truth, it is scary. I'm scared with what I see. I live in France more than I've lived in the UK. I've been here 10 years. I was in France 21, 23 years. I've never seen as much cases of mental health. And not only brain, all over the place.
So just inbred alone is enough.
That's why I'm like, I've been asking, Lord, what is it? It's what the please tell me so I can stop drinking that medicine. Because me, I told you once I went to a restaurant, I'm eating with a girl. I saw something.
What?
I didn't eat the whole day.
What?
I'm eating in a restaurant. It was in Brixton. In a restaurant. And the weather was a bit good. And out there, I said, let's sit near the thing so we can see the passers-by. I couldn't eat that day, my friends. I had soup. I don't know if I can say this. I said to them, I said, no, there's something happening here. And then I called my son Kweku. I said, Kweku, I told you one day, we went one day to Brixton. I said, people are mad in this area. I'm not going to drink water here. Please get me a drink. I said, now, what I saw, hey, even I'm thirsty, there's no drink. I'll wait until I go somewhere else. I'm sitting in a restaurant with someone eating. A young man, maybe in his 30s, I'm sorry if I have to tell you this testimony, comes past. He's sitting there. He drags his pants down, pulls diarrhea, puts his pants, and continues.
What? That story was public.
In your food?
In. People were there.
Public.
And I'm eating. I stopped. I'm like, you know, you can't even talk. I'm like, did you see what I saw? And the little girl I was eating like, yeah, yeah, let's eat. I look at my soup. I look at this. I said, please, let's go.
Yeah,
I said, how can this? I said, and I look, I said, there's a corner there. You come in the middle of people? A white person. He, no, young man. He stopped, pulled down his trousers, bent, puked, put that up, went.
On the floor. You popped it on a pavement. On a
not pavement.
In the
it was on the, you know, there's a little driveway like that. So people going here, there. People were like, it was like a movie. Like everyone was like frozen. Like, 1 second. Did I see it well? Everyone was like frozen. Isn't it devilish?
Yeah.
Sam.
So you think, is this the world we are living in? So can't we see, can't we hear, can't, won't that push you to really seek God? That's my question this morning. Won't that push you to say, Lord, you spared me this. You spared me this.
Amen.
Hey, young people around me, look at drugs. You spared me this. Won't that give you that drive to say, hey, no, you spared me this. I better be near you. Not in your house, but near you.
Amen.
Not in your house, but near you. Lord, are you standing here? Where are you? Hey, please, wait. Let me come closer. Doesn't that change something in you? Doesn't that change something in the way you behave? Doesn't that bring that anger in you? That no. If someone has to make a change, Lord, use me.
Mm-hmm.
If someone can be, I am here, just like Ayla said, I am here because I don't want to see this anymore. Does it change something in you? That's the reason why we don't see solutions in our churches, because people still don't have that anger in them that wants to, you know, look very well. The good people who did, as the good, like in the world, who did things and their name remained, is people who were fed up with the situation.
Yeah. Sure.
And they started denouncing it. They started doing something about it. But Christians, we want to say, yeah, pray God, I pray. Yes, you are praying. But God wants you to pray with that something is like, I want change. Stop praying as if, you know, we did that when we were in Catholic Church. Hey, my friend, you're still there.
Yes.
I was there too. God will help you one day. I was there a long time. I was there. Even giving Bible study with things that I didn't know. I did Bible study for 4 years. In Catholic Church, they give me the rule structure, you give it. But when they, I remember when I turned back, like, I didn't even remember what I was teaching. Of course, I was reciting what I was given. That's the problem. But God wants us to pray Him. Pray with something in there that comes out, because this is where the Spirit of God is.
Yeah, sure.
He wants you to express it. So it's like, yes, now I hear and I will do something. When you're calling on the Lord with that, you know, we have examples in the Bible. Moses was running from Egypt with the people of God. Pharaoh was behind him. Moses found himself now before that sword of death, the Red Sea. My friend, what did he do? That's all. We are like, hey, my friends. The sea, he didn't tell me there was sea. He didn't tell me it's going to be hot. You start, you know, you even start accusing God first. You didn't tell me. Moses looked at this. Hey, we're together here, yeah? Okay, good. Just put that thing I gave you, because it's already in you.
Sure.
Just because you don't know it, it's already in you. What God has given you is already in you. If you don't use it, the rod Moses had is already in you. But you don't know how to use it. That's why you're suffering. When something comes, take that rod. Red Sea. It's not what you're doing. God just wants you to take that Red Sea. But it depends on your relationship with Him. Because you can put there, the sea becomes even bigger. It becomes bigger. Doubles. Boom! Yourself all in there. But no, if you have that right relationship with the Lord, it can do like that. The sea will open and you'll go through. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're the children of God. We have the rod. He has given us the word of God. He has given us so much, so many things. And the problem is that we also forget that the promises of God are made to become real.
Amen.
So many people doubt. The Bible says in the book of James that doubt is like a double-minded person. When you doubt, you are double-minded. It is yes, it is no, it is no, it is yes, it is yes, it is no. God is like, well, okay, now, which one do I take? No or yes?
Mm-hmm.
If you believe, you believe. Faith shouldn't be wavering. Today, yes, or because you see the sun. Tomorrow, no, because you see the snow. Well, there's still be snow and sun every day. Until we die, tribulations are here. Until Jesus returns, tribulations are here. No one of us can escape it.
Yeah.
So be encouraged to continue.
Amen.
And when it comes, you say, I have the rod. Let me go in the house of the Lord and call unto him. When you've called, you say, problem, you again here. I don't know you because I left with the Lord.
Amen.
I am free. No problem with you. You know, that's what I say. You know my motto. Problem back to
problem.
That's it. Mm-hmm. When the problem comes to me.
Return it.
Problem. Me as a problem back to problem. I have no problem.
Mm-hmm.
You're not gonna stay in my house, in my mind, in my heart.
Amen.
Full stop!
Amen.
Half, almost 2 years now?
Yeah.
Have you seen me down?
No.
You're not gonna see me down. Do you think the devil is not trying on me? Do you think he's not? He's trying. He's trying. He will try because of his work.
Mm.
But I know that the one is me stronger than the one out in the world.
Amen.
So the world cannot take in me. And when there's a problem, I kneel down. I call on the Lord and I say, problem, I've given to the Lord. Hey, wrong person, wrong time, wrong house, wrong attitude. Look at the neighbor if you want. Not in my house, not in my mind,
Amen.
Not in me. I am not here. You thought you saw me, but I'm not here. Go away.
Mm-hmm.
That's the reason why you see me dancing for the Lord every day.
Amen.
You did a great thing to serve the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My friend, keep your eyes set on the Lord. The message today is keep your eyes set on the Lord because the battle is not yours. The problems will be there. They were there before you came into the world. They will be there after. You can't change. But the battle is not yours. Do your part. Seek God. Do what God is telling you to do. Then the battle will be won.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's no secret to that. So we're going to stand up this morning. I want us to stand up. And the Bible says something. They came into the house of the Lord, just like we are here today. And when they came there, it was to say that, Lord, this battle is not ours. There are many, yes, that's fine, but we have the victory in you. You're going to say, Lord, you know what battle you've been fighting for yourself. You know what you've been doing. Now you're going to say, Lord, I give it to you. Take it. Take it. I'm no longer there. So all you're going to do from this day is continue to kneel down on it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Continue to call on him. Just like water. You know, you plant a rose, you have to water it.
Mm.
Lord, my rose hasn't come out. Water. Water in prayer and fasting.
Amen.
Lord, my plant is still not there. Water. You know, until you see the result.
Sure.
Until you see the healing. Until you see the solution. That's all. He who is up there is not sleeping. He knows. He already has the solution. But no one is coming to him to ask for it. Because you came once to say, Lord, I give you this. And then you went down and slept. Waiting for it to happen. It's not going to happen, my friends. Continue watering until you see it.
Amen.
Continue praying and fasting until you see it. That's the solution of the Lord. Because you see, sometimes the Lord gives spiritually before he materializes.
Mm-hmm.
He has already given it, but you still haven't seen it with your open eyes.
Mm.
So why do you stop praying? Yeah. Why do you stop fasting? Oh, you know, I prayed. That's why I always out here. I prayed. I said, you prayed. So did you see? No. Me, I pray until I see.
Come on.
If I haven't seen it, I don't stop. I don't stop. And even when I see, I'm like, Lord, yeah, I still need to pray because I need to keep it, yeah? I don't want the devourer or someone to come here. You've given it to me, but I know that there's some jealous wine who is there who want to get it out.
Mm.
So, pray.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us stand this morning and pray. Let us pray that Lord, you yourself, you know the battles you've taken from the Lord. You gave it and you returned and took it back. You come here, you pray, Lord, I give you this, but you went back and took it again and ran away with it. Bring it back this morning. Bring it all to this morning. Put it back. You're going to say, Lord, I give you this battle. Name the battle. Name them if you know them. Put them here. It can be your family members who are sick. It can be restoration in your life. It can be anything that you want God to do that you have not given to him or that you gave and then you took back. Give to him today. pray to him. Open your mouth. Pray. Say, Lord, today I give you this. I give you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I give you, my Lord and King and Savior. We come to you, Father God, this morning. Our battles are not ours. We give you all our battles, all the fight, Father God. No matter what, Father God, is playing in my life, in the life of your ministry, in the life of your children, we put it all down unto you. You said in your word, cast your burden unto me. Cast your burden unto me. This morning, we cast all our burden unto you. Father, take them. Take them in Jesus' name. Take all our burdens. Take the sickness in our families. Take all, Lord, mountain head, Father God, among the people that we know, among our family members. We put that all this morning, Lord of grace. We give you everything. Down. Give the Lord everything. Don't go with anything. You leave it here this morning. Because he said that they went into the temple of God. And this way they left everything to the Lord. So you give it today. Give to the Lord. Everything that is bothering you. Put everything to the Lord. You are not going back with a problem today. No one is returning with a problem today. In Jesus' name. Give all your sickness, all the problems in your family. Everything unto the Lord. This morning. In Jesus' name. Financial issues. Problems in your house. Oh Lord of grace. Everything to the Lord this morning. Give. Give to the Lord. Everything that is bothering you. Give it back to the Lord. Right now. Put it down. He said it's in the temple. In the house of the Lord. Down. Put everything down. It's no longer yours. It's no longer your battle. It is not my battle. Say it's not my battle. It's not my battle. I give it to you. It is your battle. It's the battle of God. You fight for me because you said it. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord of grace. Your battle, not ours, Lord. Oh Father God. It's God's battle. You won for us, Jesus. On the cross. You defeated Satan. Lord of grace. It's not my battle. Whatever is going through my life that is dead is not my battle. It is your battle. I give it to you. In Jesus' name. And I give a clap to the Lord for his word this morning. Amen. God is good. Amen. As you go, continue to water. You know what you've given the Lord today. Continue to water it. In Jesus' name.
I am standing on the Lord. Jesus is the Lord. Hallelujah. Standing on the Lord. Hallelujah. Standing on the Lord.
Oh,
Okay.